Hey, how's it going? I'm going to check, make sure this is on. Yep, it's rolling. I'm going to go through the equipment that's needed for painting. When I say equipment, like all the brushes and things that you need to come out here and paint. I'm outside and it's plein air painting in the Ozark Mountains in Arkansas. It's a beautiful spring, kind of cool day. And the first thing I'm going to start off with is something that's in my pocket, and it's a Leatherman tool. Leatherman tool is a multi-tool with, pliers and screwdrivers and stuff. And I have it to work on this machine. And this is called a French easel. It collapses into a little box. You can buy them at Hobby Lobby or at Michael's. And this one is a Macbeth. Jillion is a really nice one. It's larger. This is called a half size. It's not as wide. It's easy to care. The next thing I'm going to go through is my palette. A palette, I made this. It was my daughter's, and I have it out here. And basically, I like these clamps. You can buy it at a hardware store. This is a lid. You open it up. You set this to the side, and you have your palette already set up. I don't carry my paints with me. They're back at the truck, and I carry them in this bag. That way, everything's lighter. But yet it's heavy. You can put an old belt on here. I took a rope and attached it with some screw eyes and so I can carry it over my shoulder. My board, I'll show you later, goes into a carrying box. So brushes are important. I use a really nice bristle hog's hair. This is a flat, and meaning hog's hair, meaning it's thick. It'll handle this thick paint. It moves the paint around stiff. Rather than synthetic brush, is too soft and you have to water it down to move the paint around. And I like thick texture paint. Y'all see, I went through the clamps, brushes, have about three with you. A palette knife. I like a large palette knife for cleaning my surface. This is actually plexiglass rather than glass. Most of the time I use glass for my palette. Let's see. This right here, to carry it, has a lid that goes on the top. It has compression locks on it that will, lock it shut. And when you put this on here, that way it doesn't leak. I kind of lost the handle, but I like this better. I put a framing wire, and I hook it here. And that's it, Here's my coffee in the back there, and I'm ready to go. And so, always a good hat, bug spray, wear dull color because bugs are attracted to bright color. A lot of times light hits your outfit and reflects back in your painting, and that causes this painting to be a different color. Good hat. What else? That's about it, good comfortable shoes, and you'd be surprised, I can't stand at some events for 15 minutes, but when I'm out here painting, I can stand for 3-4 hours, maybe 6 hours, and I have a hurt back. Painting is so fun and exciting. You get the right materials, and there's a number of setups out there that are lighter for, if you don't want to carry something this heavy around. So anyway, I want you to get out painting. Get you a setup. There's all kinds of ways of being set up. This is kind of my setup, and I hope you can get outside and paint, and hopefully this will encourage some people on getting out and paint. So changing the world one sketch at a time. Thank you.
Hello. Well, here we are at Livingston Creek in Mountain View, Arkansas. I'm going to just kind of step away from this and let you enjoy watching me paint this. It's a beautiful stream up here. I'm not too far from the road, so you're probably going to hear some vehicles go by and my dog, Frida, who's going to be playing. So, anyway, enjoy. I'm going to lay this in and see how it goes. laying in these rocks here. primitive ball. Thank you. Put that brush up there so I don't lose it. this has a beautiful gold color to it, and kind of is nice against springtime, but there's a beautiful gold color in the yellow. Enjoyed that painting on Livingston Creek with my dog Frida. Started off with big shapes and kind of put the perspective in. Kept the color kind of gray. A lot of blues in here. Let me make sure we can see this. Yeah. So a lot of blue against the oranges in here. The complementary color of orange to blue, you know, with my palette set up, with my yellows, oranges, red, violet, blue, and green. So I have cool colors up top, and warms over here. My colors are fully saturated colors. So they are, you know, I'm mixing into this gray. This is mud from leftover from some other painting. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed.